one and all. I'm Prajurita Neo, currently pursuing BSc Honours Agriculture in Assam Agriculture University, Jorhat, Assam. So being a student of agriculture, my favorite topic will be something related to agriculture. So here, I'm here to speak about organic agriculture. So how organic agriculture will help in achieving our mission, that is developing nation. So organic agriculture is a form of agriculture where we don't use chemical, where we don't use anything that includes chemical component. Here, instead of chemical, we use compost, vermicompost, biopesticide, and in long run, that doesn't affect the soil health and also maintain the productivity. So why I prefer organic agriculture is basically what I have seen so far. In my 3-year journey, what I have seen that with each increasing day, the health of soil is deteriorating, and due to which the productivity of the crops are also decreasing. So, and that is very bad, because we need to maintain a certain amount of crop, we need to maintain certain amount of quantity to maintain the food security of our country. So in organic agriculture, what they don't use chemicals, and that doesn't lead to the deteriorating soil health. When we don't use chemical, it's advantageous, because when we use chemical, we use the pesticide, we use chemical fertilizer, and sometimes the residues that remain in the soil, and that enters in human food chains, that also affect the health of human, and sometimes that flows to the water bodies, that cause pollution in the water bodies, and that is very, very hazardous for the growth of fishes. I went to an internship in Bishwanath Sariali. It's Paboi Grains. There is a full integrated organic farming system I have seen for the first time. And there I have learned they don't use anything from outside. They use everything what is produced in their farm. They use those byproducts as a manure or as a source of nutrient for the crop. They don't need chemicals, fertilizer, they don't need pesticide to maintain the fertility of soil, to maintain the growth of crop, or to eradicate the pest. They used to maintain everything in a very organic way, and I was very fascinated when I visited there. I have seen that we don't need chemicals for a crop to grow. A crop has the ability to grow. We don't need to use chemical for its growth. It's not mandatory. We have made it mandatory. So far what I have learned from there, that we can produce one system, we can think of a system where we allow the crop to grow naturally, and we allow the soil to nurture the crop without the help of human intervention. So organic agriculture is also help in long run, because there is a concept that is sustainability, and sustainability has much to do with soil health. So when our soil health is maintained, when we don't use chemical, soil health will maintain, soil will recover its health, and soil health will be maintained, and there will be sufficient amount of nutrients, soil fertility will not be deteriorating. So there we can see a stable productivity. There, if we not see any increased productivity, but we can ensure that we will not see any decrease in productivity, there will be a stable productivity. That's why I actually prefer organic agriculture over inorganic, because here we can predict something. Here we can predict that we are going to get this much of quantity every year, because it shows a stable quantity. It doesn't decrease, because here the soil itself is nurturing the crop. Here we are not doing anything. We are not imposing anything upon soil. Here we are not deteriorating its health. So if we are able to produce sufficient amount of food, that is going to cut down the price of import. And if somehow we can also enhance the productivity, because nowadays new technology is coming, nowadays new things are coming, like we can use, instead of pesticide, we can use biopesticide, like instead of compost, chemical compost, we can use compost, vermicompost, which are very rich in nutrients. We can also use rock phosphate, so which are very rich in chemical. If somehow we are able to increase the productivity every year, then we can also contribute it to the export. We can earn from the export. So what I feel, in long term, this is also going to improve the economic condition of our country in the form of GDP. So organic agriculture will also contribute to the GDP, and also it will not deteriorate the health of soil, which in return maintain the same productivity, and will not make the human being exposed to the chemical residues that is present in the soil sometimes, and that also cause some diseases. Though the productivity of organic agriculture is little bit less, but yes, we can enhance it. But what we can conclude is that the productivity may not increase, but it will not decrease. It will maintain a certain position. It will give a stable productivity. It will give a stable yield every year. And from there, we can predict that which crop we are going to allow to the organic agriculture, which crop are essentials, which crop are very necessary that we can allow to organic agriculture. And there comes the important export thing. If we are able to produce the crop that we used to import from other country, then it will be helpful that we can cut down that price too. We can allow that much of area for that crop also. And if somehow that productivity is increased, then we can use it for exporting also. And nowadays it's in trend. People prefer organic food because they have seen the effect of chemicals. They have seen the what I have mentioned already, this chemical residues. They have seen all this, and therefore they now the people also now the consumer also prefer organic foods, and this also again contribute to the economy of our country. So what I have seen in return, organic agriculture is somehow little bit also contribute to the developing nation, to make us our country develop. Thank you.